Begin by settling into your body and getting comfortable. Finding a position that feels comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. In any case, allow your body to get comfortable. Noticing what that feels like, and really enjoying any sensations of comfort in the body, even if they're small. And relax your body, noticing if there's any tension anywhere in your body and gently inviting those places to relax, to loosen, to let go. Again, allowing yourself to enjoy those sensations, to savor the feelings of relaxation that arise in your body, even if they're small. Very profound. The more you notice these things, the more you enjoy them. And the more you enjoy them, the more likely they are to return. If you'd like, you can bring a gentle, easy smile to your face. Just a simple smile. Doesn't have to be a huge grin. And enjoying this configuration of your body, being comfortable and relaxed with a gentle, easy smile of your on your face. Wherever there's any kind of pleasure, pleasant sensations, enjoyment, happiness in your body. Noticing that and savoring it. Delighting in those sensations. Without losing these qualities in the body, comfort and relaxation, smiling, begin to involve your mind. reflecting on aspects of your life that you're grateful for, whatever that might be for you. Grateful for my friends. Grateful that I have a place to sleep and food to eat. Grateful that I have work that I enjoy and I'm skilled at. Grateful for the opportunity to be of benefit, to serve others. Take a few moments to consider what you're grateful for and to tell yourself about it. Whatever it is that you're grateful for, be sure that you can hear it in your mind. If you're in a quiet space, you can even say it out loud. Either way, tell yourself what you're grateful for. Very good. Now, bring to mind your easy to love person or animal, whoever that is for you. Someone who you have a simple relationship with that you care for and want to be happy. Be a real person, friend, family member. Small child, pet, even someone imaginary. Begin to cultivate love, metta, friendliness for this person. Perhaps by using phrases as we did just now with gratitude. I care about you so much. I love you so deeply. I want you to be so happy. May you be happy. Or any phrase that resonates for you. You can also simply visualize them being happy using a memory that you shared with them, or just visualizing them smiling or laughing, playing. Or you can directly feel into love in your heart and direct that love towards them. However you choose to do it, cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal. Continue to cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal for another moment. Whatever extent you've cultivated love, that you feel love in your heart, feel free to keep that around, to maintain it and even to grow it, even as we transition into the main technique. For this practice period, we'll be practicing praying for ourselves. There are many ways to pray, of course. If we choose to do so, we can find a way that feels good for us. You can explore who you're praying to. You can, of course, pray to the divine, some sense of God or the gods, however you conceive of the divine. You could also pray to your guides or your ancestors or to a spiritual figure, teacher that inspires you. You pray to your highest self. You can explore what makes sense to you and feels good for you. A lot of times we understand prayer as something verbal, or we say phrases in our minds, praying to someone or for something. That's certainly valid. But you can also pray with images in your mind or, again, simply with feelings in your body. Can feel into what seems right for you. When you have a sense of that, begin to pray for yourself. You might pray for your safety and health, your well-being, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual. You might pray for specific quality to enter your life or your heart. Patience, kindness, love, wisdom. There are many, many, many ways to pray. Explore what feels right to you right now and do that. Or if for whatever reason praying doesn't feel quite right, feel free to do a different technique, a different cultivation practice, loving kindness or compassion or something like that. Even another technique entirely. You always get to decide what and how to practice. You know yourself best. If it feels good, if it feels right, pray for yourself. Explore that. Very good. Now, take a moment to look back on this practice period. What's it been like for you? What happened in your heart and your mind? Is there anything that you learned that might be useful for you in the future? Take a moment to reflect, to consider. As you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.